This is, I hate the way this comes across.
It's like I've wanked off Casper.
Wow.
I like that a lot.
No idea is too stupid.
Ignore it. That will come in the future for sure.
Sí, buenos mañana, señor Spiffy.
Today's a good day. Gonna kick things off with a nice edit. I told you yesterday that we're gonna get stuck in, we're gonna go deep into the editing journey today. Like kind of sharing what I do, how I think, how I edit a full TikTok, start to finish. Wow. Excited? I know you're excited. You're very excited, aren't you? And then I wanted to brainstorm a bit this afternoon of how the socials automation piece, which is taking clips from this, sticking them on social media as like fan accounts, it's not working. Maybe it is that I can't see. Like, my underlying goal was we get the clips out on these fan accounts and they generate exposure to the point that someone sees these clips enough times that they are like, who is this dude? I need to go and search up who this is so I can hit not interested on every platform. But those clips, none of them seem to be doing that well. And I think I'm wondering if I should put a bit of my own time into editing like one type of compilation clip or putting a bit more thought into one of the edits each day and seeing if that gets us anywhere. I don't know what that is. I mean, I have a couple of ideas, but I think just clearing off the whiteboard, throwing ideas down and seeing what we get, just open box, that's not the term for it. I don't know what the term is, where you just, no idea is too stupid. Maybe we'll use ChatGPT to help because that's my best friend at the moment. Yeah. Let's see how that goes. I like the idea of the intros that I have where it's almost like a load of clips that make up a 10 to 15 second sentence that kind of makes sense but also doesn't. I quite like that. Anyway. All right, let's get stuck into the edit. See you shortly.
This on? My juicy bambino, let's do this, okay? Got the SSD in the pouch. And should I bring you a bit closer? Let's see, ooh, hello. Share my screen. Let's get everything else out. All right. So the edit we're gonna work on is part 5 of the sauna series. We're gonna do a slightly different, I recorded the voiceover to be slightly different, okay? I want it to be a bit more as if I did something, I did an experience, and I'm just explaining the experience. Now that doesn't mean I'm gonna be changing the style of everything that goes into a video. But it does mean that I would like it to seem less of, I did this thing and it's amazing, you should, because that's not it. I don't want to go that route. Okay, so if I show you my folder structure here, I have the few projects that I'm working on. So everything on my SSD, so SSD in here. Everything on here is a work in progress. Or it's files that I use for every project. So like in this case, the insults and the intros come out of my PodVlogs and I store them in there to make compilations, sound effects, all my, of course. And then some projects I'm working on here, the at-home sauna, this hover air one, which I'm excited to release hopefully this week, that gets approved, and a few other ones. And then we have my template folder here, which is for every project. This is essentially what I copy over, I hit Command D, and then I just rename it as I need to. And this command, that project has a template project like this. Actually, let me just show you. So if I open this one, select it, we have the 1080p template, which is what I use for the YouTube video, which is in YouTube format at the top here. And then we have audio, which the naming doesn't make any sense, but this is where I have all my sound effects, and they're kind of set up in the right place so that I can almost copy and paste onto a TikTok and then just adjust, make minor adjustments as needed. And then we have the clips, which is a vertical format and is where I take the clip sections from my long YouTube video. I'll put them into here and make any small edits I need to. Cool. So let's go. I mentioned this in a video recently, but I would obviously do part one first, and then I would right click, duplicate the project, and that would give me part two, which is a project of everything that was in part one, and I would add to the beginning of that. The reason I do that is so that in this same timeline that you see at the bottom here, I have all of my footage from the previous video that I can reference back to. So as I try and keep the format the same, and I have all these clips, I can just drag them over without having to go in between projects. So today we have finished with part four, and we're going to go on to part five. So I'm duplicating the project, going into it, going to the beginning, zooming back in, and pressing Option W to give me a spacer or whatever you want to call this. Then I change up my workload screen. I do have different windows that I use, my different workspaces, which I haven't used in a long time, but yeah, there's my general editing one. So from there, I have my folder with all of my footage in it, and it's sorted by the camera that was used. So I know that A7S III is gonna have my like voiceover clips. So I drag those onto the timeline. And step one is to go through and cut all these up. So let's do that now. So yes, this is a new style of video, and I was playing around with different ways of saying this. Expecting it to So let's cut everything else out here. And I have the Logitech MX Master 3 set up with all the different shortcuts for Final Cut Pro. And so like these buttons here remove everything before or after. I mean, you know, if you need to, if you would like it, we can go through what my different button setups are, but. So then I'll go in, and I'm just doing rough cuts at the moment. So then normally my last take is the best one.
The heat immediately hit me. The heat immediately. Nothing could have prepared me for the crazy temperature change from the 40 degrees outside to the 5 minutes on the timer. It immediately hit me.
Okay.
Nothing could have prepared me.
So there'll be some clearing up to do once I finish this section.
I wanted to see how much weight I'd lose was pouring out of. Sweat was pouring out of me. Weirdly, it was like I could. That was all intended.
So notice that I'm cutting at the end of a section here. So just a cut, and then I'm using whatever tool this is called to delete everything before that. instead of cutting and then moving my mouse to delete it. And these are small shortcuts that you learn over time that, you know, may each only save me 2 or 3 seconds at a time. Over the course of a full edit will save me, you know, a couple of minutes, maybe more.
But if I push that door open, and winning these small mental battles.
I changed up the script here, so let's delete that. God, that, I thought that script was going to be way longer, which is quite good. So then, I will go in here and add in. Well, I guess I can just show you as I do it, can't I? So I'm going to go frame by frame at the end of each of these clips. I actually prefer to do this by mouse. So I'm the Control S command. Like semi separates the audio track from the video so that I can make the audio slide underneath the next clip so that instead of it sounded like the sentence finishes and then you start the next one, the sentence is finishing as you start the next one. Very nicely explained.
The heat immediately hit me and...
So I think the gap in here is too long. So I'm just going to take out a couple of bits.
I was worried with the front gate. I wanted to see how much weight.
Cool, dude. So sometimes I don't need to move too much, and I've actually done a pretty good job here of cutting where the audio starts and ends. You know what's very interesting is I saw this clip last night of Justin Bieber and I can't remember the name of the orchestra, and he's working with them. He's giving them a pitch and a rhythm that he wants, and they're able to do it there and then in that second. And from the outside looking in, you think, God, the pressure in that moment. Like, you've got Justin Bieber, he's probably paying you so much money to be there, and if you mess up, like, that's terrible in that situation. But you start to realize that these people are experts in what they do, and where I think playing an instrument like that and making mistakes, I would just make mistakes all the time. Those people are professionals at what they do, they're experts at what they do, and doing that is second nature. There's no thought in their mind of, I might mess up. It's, I'll just do this thing because I already know how to do it. And it, for me, it's the same with editing, and for anything that you've had a lot of experience with, it's likely the same. But we quite often overlook that when we've been in something for so long, we don't realize how good we've gotten at it. Like, that difference between being a complete beginner to being whatever level you're at, we think that gap is only this big, but actually it's just a chasm. So then my next step in here is to look back at my script and see if there are any parts that I've labeled out as having direct quotes in the video. So, like, one of them is here, Jinkies, it's 150 in here now. And that is after how much weight I lose.
Nothing could have prepared me for the crazy temperature change from the 40 degrees outside. I already soaked socks for the first to go, but they didn't give me much relief from the heat. I wanted to see how much weight I'd lose, so I weighed myself before and...
And while I'm doing this, like, this probably isn't the right way to do this. But I know I'm not going to do that yet, but I will put a marker here.
Made myself before at 106.
Oh, that's not right. I was getting the right clip. Oh, it's the first clip I have. So, like, in here.
Weight I'd lose, so I weighed myself before at.
That mirror is gross.
At 161 pounds, and at the halfway point, the sweat was pouring out of me.
So, jinkies, it's 150 in here now. So I'll go back to this section. Go to the clip in here where I say jinkies, it's 150. Here. And I might have that showing up there. We'll see. I might have to adjust those. What else do we have? I think we have the final clip. I know I have my reaction to stepping in, which is back down here.
The heat immediately falls for $50.
Okay. So then for this section, because I don't know where that shot is, I'll just add in a spacer knowing that something's going to go in there. And then the final bit.
Minutes.
Is that what I wanted? Yes. So then I'll put this back toward the end. What did I say here?
Give updates until I stop sweating.
So I actually will do this, and then that will go toward in here, and then the final shot is going to be the cryotherapy changer I show. I think it's this one. Yes, this bit. And then I'll make cuts to that later. Now, I will go through and make markers as to where I'm going to put different clips that I know I've shot.
I'm trying a futuristic infrared sauna for day 5 of my sauna journey.
Struggling in sauna.
5 of my sauna journey because the cheaper one I had because cheaper.
Previous at home sauna. So these markers I'm adding are to-do markers, and when you click on one of them, you can set it as completed, which is quite nice to do.
Bro, expecting it to cost an arm and a leg, I found one just up the road. Arm and a leg,
I think. Like where, instead of adding the to-do markers for these, I'm just gonna go through like chronologically and get clips like this. And then, damn it. Going in.
Just up the road, they gave me reset.
And then perhaps, don't need all of this bit. I always overfilm. So then maybe a shot here of me. like showing this. And I might split out this with the clip of me stepping in. It depends what the shot of my reaction looks like.
The heat immediately hit me, and with 55 minutes on...
So I've got 55 minutes on the timer. Bit of a movement shot.
And with 55 minutes on the timer, I was worried what the front desk lady would think if I gave up before that. The heat immediately hit me, and with...
I think in here I do... wiping sweat off head. I might keep this section as talking to the camera. I feel like it gives a more relaxed approach and shows that I'm just a guy who's now sat here telling the story.
Lady would think if I gave up before that. Nothing could have prepared me for the crazy temperature change from the 40 degrees outside. Desk lady would think if I gave up before. Desk lady would think. Nothing could have prepared me for the crazy temperature change from the 40 degrees outside to the 144 degrees inside.
How would I show this shot? I don't know, let's not think about that yet. We can look at footage.
My already soaked socks were the first to go, but... they didn't give me much relief from the heat. I wanted to see how much weight I'd lose, so I weighed myself before at 100.
I think I need more of me stepping on the scales.
Jinkies, it's 150 in here.
Get the volume up. So I will bring the footage in and bring the audio out.
The sweat was pouring out of me faster than I could pour out my... Weirdly, it was like I could feel my body cleaning itself. That would feel weird.
Clip in sauna. Not sure what though.
My body cleaning itself. That was all until about the 40-minute mark, where breathing became difficult.
Breathing and changing positions. So I think maybe I could have this section as me talking to camera. Because I don't need anything. And then this is where...
Stopping was quite literally the push of a door.
Looking at door.
quite literally the pushed door away. But if I push that door open, the lady out front would know that I gave up early. Now, these small mental battles may seem insignificant, but winning them makes us stronger for...
I think sat up, breathing, counting down. Because I did a section from like 5 minutes where I did five and then four, three. Yep, you get the idea.
Seem insignificant, but winning them makes us stronger for tomorrow.
Very nice, Oliver. Woo!
Open, the lady out front would know that I gave up early. Now, these small mental battles make... But if I push that door open, the lady out front...
Maybe on camera? I'm not sure yet.
Cryotherapy freeze chamber. Try that next time.
That's the ending. Okay, so now I will grab my big piece of footage. There's only 50 gig of it, okay? So, what? 20 gig, 29 meg, okay. So let's delete you. And then I'll open up my index on the left, which tells me the tags that I've added. I think I should add... Darn it. I don't want you seeing the outline of my, well, if there is even an outline of my crotch. So I guess I'm going to be doing a blur, a Gaussian blur. I should use the bulge. Should I see what that looks like? Is it called bulge? What's it called? Distortion. Yeah, I don't think fisheye is going to be the one, is it? Because that's just going to make it look way bigger. Yeah, I don't think that would. I think I'm thinking bulge would be funny just because I think the effect is called bulge. And if you didn't know that, you wouldn't get it. You might have to see me walking in here. Where's my reaction? Did I film my reaction from my phone? That's a good shot for the sweat, isn't it?
Immediately hit me, and with 55 minutes on the timer, the desk lady would think for that. Nothing could have prepared me for the crazy temperature change from the 40 degrees outside.
So then maybe that is a good shot. Or is it? Let's see.
The halfway point. Jinkies, it's 150. My already soaked socks were the first to go, but...
Where's the sweat dripping bit? Here?
The sweat was pouring out of me faster than I could pour out my toxic thoughts in my daily vlog. Weirdly, it was like...
Maybe that's right. Let's say that's completed.
Nothing could have prepared me for the crazy temperature change outside. It's 144 degrees to
I like that shot. I like that a lot.
Crazy temperature change from the 40 degrees outside to the 144 degrees inside. My or
whoopsies. Okay. The thing that I find really annoying, I think I'm gonna have to change this. Maybe I'll do the, I don't know, audio changes afterwards. But because I'm like a frame one way or the other, when I bring in clips, I have to zoom in to the timeline to make sure that it's not like, you know, over here, which seems messy to me. And I like it, the clip starting when I start to say one thing and finishing when I finish that thought. Like, I think the clips should line up with the start and end of a, either a sentence or a word. What other clips do we have here? I didn't even get a shot of my reaction, did I?
The heat immediately hit.
So maybe I'll just go from here. Oh yeah, my back. Yes, we like that. Where should we put you, Mr. Oliver? I think here. Get rid of that. That can go up there.
Heat immediately hit me and immediately hit. The heat immediately hit me and.
I think that's too quick.
The heat immediately hit me and with 55 minutes on the timer, I was worried with the front desk lift. And with 55 minutes on the timer, I was worried what the front desk lady would think if I gave up before that. Nothing could have prepared me for the crazy temperature change from the 40 degrees outside to the 100.
Maybe this is actually a better clip to go in here.
Nothing could have prepared me for. Nothing could have prepared me for the crazy temperature change from the 40 degrees outside to the 144 degrees inside.
I think that's better, actually. And then here we'll have the shot of me going into the sauna. Yes. Very nice, Oliver. Yes, excellent.
The heat immediately hit me.
Then, of course, we need to adjust the mask. Like, I know I don't need to have the mask here, but I think it's very important because, like, I need to remember that this is video that's going online, and while I don't want to be targeting young kids. Number one, because I don't think they'll get the intricacies of the of what I'm trying to do, but also because that's not, you know, my style of humor isn't for that age group. So when I have things like this where I am in my boxers and it's slightly revealing, you like when you think about it on paper, I'm a 32-year-old man and I'm putting myself on my boxers online in front of any age group, that's weird. It's so weird.
The heat immediately hit me, and with 55 minutes on the timer, I was worried what the front desk lady would think if I gave up before that. Nothing could have prepared me for the crazy temperature change from the 40 degrees outside to the 144 degrees inside. My already soaked socks were...
Okay, let's get the socks off. Skim across. Oh, there they are. Hey, bring that in.
My already soaked sock. My already soaked socks were the first to go, but they didn't get.
So I don't think, obviously I don't need all of this.
Give me much relief from the heat. I wanted to lose. My already soaked socks were the first to go, but they didn't give me much relief from the heat. I wanted to, my already soaked socks were the first to go. How much weight?
Perhaps. I don't need as much of taking the socks off as I do of just like showing that they're leaving the room.
My already soaked socks were the first to go, but they didn't give me much relief from the heat. I wanted to see how much weight I'd lose, so I weighed myself before. Go, but they didn't give me much relief. Go, but.
And then a shot of me struggling in the heat. Wiping forehead. Nice. You see how it's just slowly coming together bit by bit?
I wanted to see how much weight I'd lose, so I weighed myself before and I'd lose. So I weighed myself before at 161 pounds and at the halfway point. So I weighed myself before at 161 pounds and at the halfway point.
Jinkies, it's 150 in here now.
The sweat was pouring out of me faster than I could pour out my toxic thoughts in. Weirdly, it was like I could.
How to get daily vlog shots in? I want this to be. Yes, I want it to be a plug so that people know I have a daily vlog. But I don't want it to seem like an advertisement. Like, I see me having a vlog is. And advertising that is really not that much different to me trying to sell a t-shirt or something, because really it's just a shift of selling. Instead of selling a product, you're trying to buy someone's time, right? And I hate this idea of making someone go subscribe. I'd much prefer someone go subscribe because they have wanted to go subscribe, not because they feel like they've been compelled to by someone else, right?
Weirdly, it was like I could feel my body cleaning it.
So let's get a shot of me. Just looking for a good shot here. That's quite a good shot. If I do that. Yes, Oliver. Yes. Very nice. Two, eight.
Weirdly, it was like I could feel my body cleaning itself. That was all until about.
So done.
Until about the 40-minute mark where breathing became difficult. Minute mark where
do I have a clip of 40 minutes? I don't think I do. I think think I have a shot of me here. A shot of me here, and then another shot in a different position. This, I think that was the most comfortable position. I think head down is quite powerful. I think here. Let me zoom in. Get a nice shot. God, I'm so skinny, aren't I? I couldn't believe I was 161 pounds at the end. Oh, before. That's outrageous. Okay, let's get this. This shot here with the... I think we've got lots of shots there. I need to make some small adjustments to the blur. This was...
That was all until about the 40-minute mark where breathing became...
Okay, I'm just putting a marker there so I know that the other clips... Cool, dude. There. I don't think we need the shifting of the position. I don't need that one, I don't think, because I've already gotten one. Breathing became difficult, and then these shots. So I think I won't need all of these, but I do need to adjust them. I need much less than what's here. But I am obviously trying to emphasize. Actually, I don't like that cut. Let's do it going down into this position. Get these up on here. So from here. Now here's a little tactic.
Where breathing became difficult.
So instead of doing it per word, which I don't think makes that much sense, I take the number of frames here. So if I'm working on a 24 frame timeline times 4 gives us 96. We'll do 96 plus 11 frames gives us 107 frames. If we do 107 divided by 4, it means that each frame gets about 26 frames. So then I grab each of these and set them to 26 frames and just adjust them along here. And then some of them will get, like, let's say, I think these are the most impactful. So if I do that, how many frames are left? 3 frames. So turn the magnetism off. Got the TISM.
Or my Sutra try.
Done, completed, get out. This I can delete as well. And then here, let's find a clip of me looking at the door. I know there's a clip of me looking at the door. Oops, sorry. Is it here? I think this is actually a pretty good shot. Like that shows that I'm dead, I'm almost done. Looking at door, sure, we can fit you in there.
If stopping was... stopping was quite literally the push of a door away. But if I was quite literally the...
I don't like my face being covered with a towel as much.
Stopping was quite literally the push of a door away. But if I put... But if I...
Okay, cool, yeah. On camera. And now the phone, oh wait, that was on camera. Was there a clip? I thought I needed, I'm not sure, but I will look for. Where is it?
5 minutes left.
Here.
The lady out front would know that I gave up early. Now these small mental battles.
Here we go.
5 minutes left. My camera just overheated. My head is pounding.
Oh dear. Let's don't move a muscle. Don't move, Oliver. And go get, oh, shit on it. Where's the blur? Blur. Why's the blur up so high? Okay.
If I push that door, would know that I gave up early. 5 minutes left. My camera just overheated. My head is pounding. Now these small mental battles may seem insane.
Oh, it's quite nice, Oliver. Countdown. Okay. Let's get the blur down here. Make it way smaller. And now I'm looking for where I count down. Three minutes. There's 1 minute, okay. We missed 2 minutes. Cool. Two minutes. Uno minuto. So then these clips will all fit in here. And we'll set them as going on. So there's 302. So 3 times 24, 60, 72. 74 divided by 3, 24 and a half. So we'll do each of these at 24. And then I'll just make the other clip line up toward the end. Oh, okay, perfect.
Significant, but winning them makes us strong. Small mental battles may seem insignificant, but winning them makes us strong.
Oh, dude, that is saucy. Okay, let's crop in here, start making some slight edits.
The lady out front would know that I gave up early.
5 minutes left, my camera just overheated. My head...
Get those.
See how much weight I'd lose. I wanted to see how much weight... I was worried with the front.
What's this? Wiping sweat off hedge.
Immediately hit me.
Yeah, I don't think I need that.
Expecting it to cost an arm and a leg, I found one just up the road that gave me 3 sessions for 50 buckaroonies. The heat immediately.
Okay. So I think I'm just going to delete audio on these. I don't think actually there's any of the clips in here. Apart from that one. Damn it. Okay. I'm just going to play it through now.
I'm trying a futuristic infrared sauna for day 5 of my sauna journey because the cheaper one I had broke. Expecting it to cost an arm and a leg, I found one just up the road that gave me 3 sessions for 50 buckaroonies. The heat immediately hit me, and with 55 minutes on the timer, I was worried what the front desk lady would think if I gave up before that. Nothing could have prepared me for the crate I gave up before that. Nothing could have prepared me for the crazy temperature change from the 40 degrees outside to the 144 degrees inside. My already soaked socks were the first to go, but they didn't give me much relief from the heat. I wanted to see how much weight I'd lose, so I weighed myself before at 161 pounds, and at the halfway point...
Jinkies, it's 150 in here now.
The sweat was pouring out of me faster than I could pour out my toxic thoughts in my daily vlog. Weirdly, it was like I could feel my body cleaning itself. That was all until about the 40 minutes...
I think... I'm zoomed in here.
Oh, my body cleaning itself. That was all until about the 40 minute mark where breathing became difficult and I was performing the Kama Sutra.
Oh yes, change the mask. So we can make that much smaller.
The Kama Sutra trying to get
So let's delete the mask here and just copy it over from that previous clip because it makes sense.
Comfortable. Stopping was quite literally the push of a door away. But if I push...
Let's crop in on my face, maybe.
Push of a door away. But if I push that door open, stopping was quite literally the push of a door away. But if I push that door open, the lady out front would know that I gave up early.
5 minutes left. My camera just overheated. My head is pounding. 5 minutes left.
Come on, get this.
My camera just overheated. My head is pounding.
Now these small mental battles may seem insignificant, but winning them... makes us stronger for...
So here's a choice I have. These 3 clips here of doing 3, 2, 1, I'm a long way away, and... You could say it would be good to zoom in to show what my fingers are doing, but I like the idea of being far from the camera, that kind of loneliness. And I wonder if actually, just test this out. So I've made it into a compound clip, and let's start in. Maybe that's too much. Start cropped in, and then zoom out.
Now these small mental...
Darn it. Other way around.
Battles may seem insignificant, but Now these small mental battles, pounding. Now these small mental battles may seem
That's too much. I want it to be more dramatic, which would make it far slower.
Now these small mental battles may seem insignificant, but winning them.
I don't like how it's not centered. See what it looks
like. These small mental battles may seem insignificant, but winning them makes us stronger for tomorrow.
Cryotherapy freeze chamber. Try that next time.
Hi, I'm liking this.
I was worried what the front desk lady would think if I gave up before that. Nothing could have prepared me for the crazy temperature change from the 40 degree.
Maybe this is a crop in.
Change from the 40 degrees outside to the 144 degrees inside. My already soaked socks were the first to go, but they didn't give me much relief from the heat. I wanted to see how much weight I'd lose, so I weighed myself before at 161 pounds, and at the halfway point,
Jinkies, it's 150 in here now.
The sweat was pouring out of me faster than I could pour out my toxic thoughts in my daily vlog. Weirdly, it was like I could feel my toxic thoughts in my daily vlog. Weirdly, it was like I could feel my body cleaning itself. That was all until about the 40. Weirdly, it was like I could feel my body cleaning itself. That was all until about the 40 minute mark where breathing.
So you're thinking here, having a stabilizer effect on me, on like my chest, sorry, my bones. Track editor. Quite like that. See what it looks like.
Weirdly, it was like I could feel my body cleaning itself.
That yeah,
was
I like all
that. Until about the 40 minute mark where breathing became difficult and I was performing the Kama Sutra trying to get comfortable. Stopping was quite literally the push of a door away. But if I push that door open, the lady out front would know that I gave up early.
5 minutes left, my camera just overheated. My head is pounding.
Now these small mental battles may seem insignificant, but winning them makes us stronger for tomorrow.
I like that. Dude, that's sweet. I like that a lot.
I'm trying a futuristic.
See, I'm wondering, we'll try a few different things here. So I'm gonna set a marker. I'm gonna do a shot of the sauna. So let's get that. That's the phone clip. I kind of want to use a shot of me like struggling. A couple of clips I like here now.
Where breathing became difficult, battles significant, but
overheated.
The lady out stopping was quite literally.
The sauna actually looks quite futuristic.
Stopping, trying to get comfortable, was performing the Kama Sutra, trying to get comfortable, was performing.
Let's use this clip and maybe as I'm getting my feet in the air. Yes.
Infrared sauna for day five. Sauna for day five of my sauna journey because for day it's sauna for day five.
And then What would be good to go in there next? What did I have?
Okay. I have my sword, infrared sword. For day 5 of my sword.
Okay.
5 of my sauna journey because sauna journey.
I think.
Because.
And then. I get a shot from the previous sauna being stupidly broken.
Getting dehydrated. After day 1 of home sauna journey. My 5-day home sauna journey.
I'm not sure, we'll see. Wonder if these two would be good.
Because the cheaper one I had broke. Expecting it to cost an arm and a leg, I found one just the one I had broke.
Oh, I do have. Is it on my phone? I think it might be. Where is it? I found it. Here, share. I think I gotta go help my wife with groceries. Bring them in. Yeah, she's just down the road. Let me throw this clip in. Gonna go here.
There's a hole down here stitch.
Okay, let's see if that works. And then I think I get
arm and a leg. I'm trying a future.
Alright, I'm gonna go help Shay. I'll be right back. I don't know how you're feeling, but I think this is a very good place to stop the video at. This is a great screenshot.
I'm trying a futuristic infrared sauna for future.
See, I think I should actually have a clip in here. This bit.
I'm trying a futuristic infrared sauna for day futuristic.
See.
I'm trying a futuristic infrared sauna for day 5 of my sauna journey because the cheaper one I had broke. I'm trying a futuristic infrared sauna for day 5 of my sauna journey because the cheaper one I had broke for 50 buckaroonies. The heat immediately hit me, and with 55 minutes on the timer, I was worried what the front desk lady would think if I gave up before that. Nothing could have prepared me for the crazy temperature change from the 40 degrees outside to the 144 degrees inside. My already soaked socks were the first to go, but they didn't give me much relief from the heat. I wanted to see how much weight I'd lose, so I weighed myself before at 161 pounds, and at the halfway point,
jinkies, it's 150 in here now.
The sweat was pouring out of me faster than I could pour out my toxic thoughts in my daily blog. Weirdly, it was like I could feel my body cleaning itself. That was all until about the 40 minute mark, where breathing became difficult and I was performing the Kama Sutra trying to get comfortable. Kama Sutra trying to get comfortable. Stopping was quite literally the push of a door away. But if I push that door open, the stopping was quite literally the quite lit.
I think I go from here.
Push of a door away.
And then, I wonder what that looks like.
Stopping was quite literally the push of a door away. But if I push that door open, the lady. Was quite literally the push of a door away. But if I push. Stopping was quite literally the push of a door away. But if I push that door open, the lady out front would know that I gave up early.
5 minutes left, my camera just overheated. My head is pounding.
Now these small mental battles may seem insignificant, but winning them makes us stronger for tomorrow.
Cryotherapy freeze chamber. Try that next time.
I quite like this. I don't want to add sound effects because I think those sound effects give it a more edited tone. It's interesting how I've slowly migrated away from wanting to add in specialty shots that are shot just to go along with what I'm saying, but wouldn't normally be shot by someone who was just telling, like, just a random person who picked up a story and did a thing. I've moved away from that, and then I wanted to go into, like, nice, clever shots. And I've moved away from those. And now, my clips are just very basic. And then they're just layered on top of my story. And I think now I'm slowly bringing it further and further back to as basic as I can, but still with the heavy-duty storyline underneath.
I'm trying a futuristic infrared sauna for day 5 of my sauna.
It's tough. There's a part of me that's saying it would be good to have your face right at the beginning. But that's also the most important part of the video, and if you don't have a shot that captures people.
I'm trying a futuristic infrared sauna for day 5 of my sauna journey because.
Let me think. Is there a shot of me getting out and how red I am?
Alright, 5 minutes post sauna, still sweating like a pig, just clearing up. My boxers, it was like I'd been swimming, they were so wet. Pig, just clearing up.
I quite like that shot, actually. It both shows me, like, there's a part, this is, I hate the way this comes across. But if you think about this, instead of just me or person, you think about this being a brand, you would like people to immediately know the brand when they see it, and that brand is my face. And so by having my face at the beginning, people can immediately associate if they want to watch that or not. So, like, maybe that clip. Alright, should we see what this looks like?
I'm trying a futuristic infrared sauna for day 5 of my sauna journey because the cheapo one I had broke. Expecting it to cost an arm and a leg, I found one just up the road that gave me 3 sessions for 50 buckaroos. The heat immediately hit me, and with 55 minutes on the timer, I was worried what the front desk lady would think if I gave up before that. Nothing could have prepared me for the crazy temperature change from the 40 degrees outside to the 144 degrees inside. My already soaked socks were the first to go, but they didn't give me much relief from the heat. I wanted to see how much weight I'd lose, so I weighed myself before at 161 pounds, and at the halfway point...
Jinkies, it's 150 in here now.
The sweat was pouring out of me faster than I could pour out my toxic thoughts in my daily vlog. Weirdly, it was like I could feel my body cleaning itself. That was all until about the 40-minute mark, where breathing became difficult and I was performing the Kama Sutra trying to get comfortable. Stopping was quite literally the push of a door away. But if I pushed that door open, the lady out front would know that I gave up early.
5 minutes left. My camera just overheated. My head is pounding.
Now, these small mental battles may seem insignificant, but winning them makes us stronger for tomorrow.
Cryotherapy chamber. Try that next time.
I am very pleased with that. All right, so here's how this next part goes. I throw in a green screen layer, which sits atop my footage. What are the chances that is one frame shorter than the previous video? So then I export this. This is just to get the audio out. And then I throw this into CapCut to get the auto captions. Part 5 audio. To which then I find that this is so much better sending it to my phone to then to do the captions in CapCut. And then I then have a video file that I export back into here and layer it on top. So there aren't any choices from here. So I'm going to stop recording on the screen. And I don't know if you want to watch. There we go. If you want to watch this bit. So right click, share. So I'm airdropping it to my phone. Come on, darling. Okay. CapCut. New project. So text, auto captions, no templates, start. I found like setting my own text presets just hasn't been working, hasn't been sticking, and then it's a pain in the ass. So select all, text preset has been useless for me. The font, I really like the cherub font, but it keeps moving around in here and I can't find it every time. Bounce, sure. I don't want a flipping template. Style, use that. No effects, animation, let's do caption, spring. And then I just check to make everything fits. Yeah, don't like this font. So batch edit, select all, edit. That was balance, wasn't it? I won't use that one again. Helium, I think I quite liked.
The heat immediately hit me, and with 55 minutes on the timer, I was worried what the front desk lady would think if I gave up before that. Nothing could have prepared me for the crazy temperature change from the 40 degrees outside.
I want this as a number, not words. To the
44 degrees inside. My already soaked socks were the first to go, but they didn't give me much relief from the heat. I wanted to see how much weight I'd lose, so I weighed myself before at 161 pounds, and at the halfway point,
Jesus, it's 150 in here now.
The sweat was pouring out of me faster than I could pour out my toxic thoughts in my daily block. Weirdly, it was like I could feel my body cleaning itself. That was all until about the 40-minute mark, where breathing became difficult, and I was performing the Kama Sutra, trying to get comfortable.
The Kama Sutra. I've purposefully said this one wrong. Kama Sutra.
Trying to get comfortable. Stopping was quite literally the push of a door away. But if I pushed that door open, the lady out front would know that I gave up early.
5 minutes left. My camera just overheated. My head is pounding.
Now, these small mental battles may seem insignificant, but winning them makes us stronger for tomorrow.
Cryotherapy. Freeze chamber. Try that next time.
Okay. And then we've got our captions. I just layer those on top, green screen over the top, and the captions are decent. And then I just export and upload.
Pretty simple, really, isn't it?
And I plan on messaging, I'll send this video to the company, Restore, and see if they're interested in partnering. We'll see. Who knows? I don't know. I hope they are. All right, next, let's do, should we do, well, I need to. Let's brainstorm things we can do to get the clips from the YouTube videos onto social media and make them do better. Yeah. All right, I have written a script for ChatGPT, essentially explaining what I wanted to do, explaining what my videos are about and what the goal is here. And the final part to this is, work with me to create an innovative strategy to drive exposure to the YouTube videos through short form videos that consist of clips from my videos. Let's do an exercise where we note down ideas, no matter how ridiculous, simple or complex. Okay, let's hit enter. It's a good start. All right, let's do this stuff on the board. Ignore it, okay? Ignore it. Let's do, actually, I think compilations. Like, so some ideas that I have. So compilations would be the intros. Let's also the funny bits. Oliver being whatever. So I'm thinking like sussy. I don't know. Insults. Like where I insult myself for doing something stupid. Okay, what have we got here? Absolutely, let's brainstorm a range of innovative ideas from the simple to the outlandish. Okay, cool. So reverse teasers, create short clips that start with the conclusion or an interesting outcome of your vlog and then tease the audience with a how did it get there question. This reversal of the typical teaser format can pique curiosity. So, instead of, I don't know, just let's just call this clips. So the idea is start with a teaser. Because at the moment, every single one of these videos is just a straight cut, start and end. But it just hasn't been working, so that's not going to work. My next suggestion I had yesterday was to cut out all the pauses, but I just don't think... I'm sure that's going to make a difference. But if I'm doing that work, let's try a few other things as well. Yeah. 1 second. This one I'm not really sure. It's start with the conclusion. And then you have the clip. I guess that's what this is, isn't it? Start with teaser, yeah. Use a time lapse of your workspace or setup evolving throughout the day, accompanied by a voiceover or of key insights. I think let's do a... voiceover hook. Hi, Duda. Day in a minute montage. So get the best points. So like best of. This is compilations from other videos. Best of PodVlog number 1. Yeah, okay. Interactive polls, create interactive content where you pose a question or a challenge related to a discussion in your vlog. And direct viewers to find the answer or solution in your YouTube video. I don't know, that's not going to work. That's... I'm pretty sure that's not going to work. The way TikTok is, wouldn't work. And if it's not going to work on one platform, then I'm essentially doing double the work to get it across different platforms. I'm not a place to do that, I don't think. What should I title the intro bit? I think I should title that so that people look forward to it. But I don't know what to do with that yet. Take a currently trending challenge and give it a twist that relates to your content. For example, if there's a dance challenge, you do a few steps and probably switch to a sneak peek of your vlog content. React to series, no, because it needs to come from the YouTube channel. Like, I like this idea. I'm not sure how to make it work, but viral scavenger hunts. Create a series of short clips that, when put together, form a clue or a code leading to a hidden message or exclusive content on your YouTube channel. I do want to do that in the future. I've had this thought of when the TikTok, so it'll be a running thing on the PodVlog here, that in each TikTok there will be a discount code for merch or something that is hidden throughout the video, and if you can pick out that, if you can find it and you're within the first like 10 or 50 or whatever, then you can get like a free item or a discount code. That will come in the future for sure. behind the scenes shorts. Like, this whole thing is behind the scenes. I don't think there can be any behind the scenes to this. Can there? ...360 perspective. No, because it's coming from this camera. Someone said the other day about making it seem like people are listening to what I'm saying in the video. So have like a Twitch chat playing. Like, what if okay, I take this segment of thing that I have already spoken about, and I make it seem like a Twitch comment has come through from someone that causes me to then talk about that topic. Twitch dono topic. There's also streamer react. Where it's like, let's say I'm saying something and you have someone like Kai Sinat or Aiden Ross, who it's just a video of them reacting to something else, but you put it over the top as if they're reacting to my clip. That'd be very interesting. Okay, choose your own adventure clip. Create a series of short clips where viewers can make decisions at the end of each video, leading them through a storyline that ultimately directs them to your YouTube channel for the full story. That's essentially leaving the story untold, isn't it? Unfinished? And if they want to get the answer to it, they have to go to the YouTube channel. That can be done. I'm not sure how. Like, I guess I kind of do that in my... I think the idea of doing a video that doesn't close itself out, like a TikTok that doesn't close itself at the end, does not work because people see your content and know that they're not going to get the result from the video. There's no payoff in the video. They're not going to be like, oh, I can't wait for the next one because you'll tell me in the next video. However, what I do and why I think series on TikTok works so well is because you give the payoff for the video and then at the end you tease what the next video is going to be. And I wonder if I can do that somehow. I try doing that, but it doesn't always work out. I think that's going to require a lot of work. End with payoff and teaser. Yes. I think when I saw, because I got this whole idea from my experience with Sam Sulek, for example, let's say. So I saw tons of just random clips of him on TikTok. And I was like, who the hell is this guy? I've never seen him before, but I'm seeing him all the time. So I went to his TikTok page and all of the clips I was seeing were nothing to do with his TikTok. So I was like, okay, well, obviously the next place to go is YouTube. And that's where I found all his videos. I don't watch his videos now. But that was the way that people, like, I'm just not interested in watching that kind of long form. I don't think I have the attention span, or I don't have the time, I think is also a large part of it. And would I spend that time sat watching? No, I don't think my life constitutes that, because I think the way someone would watch this video is by sticking it up on the TV and then playing it in the background while they're on their phone, or while they while you're eating or something like that, as opposed to sitting there on your phone and intently watching for an hour. I don't know if I can see someone doing that. Do you do that? Okay, vlog trivia, post trivia questions related to your vlogs. For instance, in which vlog did I talk about not big enough yet for that, but I quite like that idea. Like, I had the idea of putting in clips from my TikToks over the top. But that would have to depend. Let's say items 1, 3. I like the film reactions to your own vlogs. Interesting. What else is there? One, two, 11, 12. Give me more ideas similar to items. Okay. This is a long vlog today, isn't it? Okay, countdown clips. Create a series of short countdown clips leading up to a major revelation or event in your vlog. Each clip can reveal a little more, building anticipation for the full story on your YouTube channel. I think I need to figure out ways to package the videos, right? A day in seconds highlight. Similar to the day in a minute concept, create ultra short clips showing a different second from your day's vlog. So maybe like the intros are called PodVlog 48 in 15 seconds. So like this one is 60 seconds. Oh, yeah, that's right. Best of, yep. In 15 seconds. Yeah. A day in seconds highlight. Interactive choose the topic clips. Post a series of short clips with different topics you've covered in your vlogs. Allow viewers to choose which topic they want to explore more, leading them to the specific YouTube video. Interesting. So it's like a compilation of topic titles and then the timing in the video. Topic hooks with time stamps. Before and after teasers. Use a split screen format to show a before scenario at the start of the vlog and after it, the result at the end. The way I'm thinking that is sometimes the topics I go through can span like 30 to 90 seconds. So what if it's the hook and then how I finish the topic? Guess the context game. Post out of context clips from your vlogs and challenges. Sorry. Post out of context clips from your vlogs and challenge viewers to guess the context or the topic being discussed. So, like, out of context, Oliver. I like this because essentially we're turning, instead of just posting clips, we're kind of turning this into new content styles. Quite like this. Flashback Friday montage. Compile brief moments from the past vlogs related to a current topic or event and present them in a quick montage. Like, I think I should take, for want of a better term, iconic sections from the vlog and turn them into like green screen CapCut memes. We'll call these edits. Green screen cap. Cut memes. I think, again, I'm probably very biased about this, but I think if someone were to have this job, like if I gave an editor this job, it would be quite fun. It's like, how can I, like, this gives full creativity, in my opinion. Like, these are very basic. Like, the intros, funny bits. Yeah, I think those are all just very basic. Similar to reverse teasers, these clips end at a crucial moment, ask the audience what happens next. The answer lies in the full vlog. Yeah, I don't like that idea. The making of, behind the scenes of how you execute parts of your vlog. I mean, you see everything, don't you? Separate but related storylines in your vlogs and use short clips to tease each one. Viewers can choose which storyline they want to follow in more detail on YouTube. Spot the difference challenge. Oh, this is a nice idea. Fill in the blanks. Essentially, you take a section of video, and while you keep the video, you mute certain parts, and the title would be like asking the user to say what they think I said. That's quite a cool idea. A lot of this requires, you know, still a lot of creativity on my end. But if I have these in mind when I'm going through the footage, then I can start tagging as I go along, can't I? I think this gives us some good places to start. Yeah. I think where I'm going to start is I'm going to look for some streamer react points. Some streamer reaction videos and just see if I can just then cut those and put them on top of content that I have. Yeah, I will give that a go. I think we should end the vlog for today. It's been a long one for you, I'm afraid. So let's finish there. Tomorrow, I mean, some things, I've got to send a contact some ideas that I have for Crocs videos. And then I've got to send a marketing video, the marketing email to Restore, which is where I got the infrared sauna done yesterday. Maybe we'll get something from that. We'll see. All right. Hope you enjoy the video. See you tomorrow, loser. You know what? I told you yesterday that I would show you how the liquid chalk works. So today, give it a go. So liquid chalk. It's going to look like I've had a good evening with Casper. Should we set a timer? Stopwatch. And I'll screen record it. Don't know why. We'll just put it on screen. Start. All right, so we rub it in. I should definitely have opened the door to my room first. This is so cool how this works. Yeah, I'll be up in a second. It's like I've wanked off Casper. Still a bit wet, but yeah, then you have like climbing chalk ready to go. I've ordered some more smelling salts. I've also ordered a quick release plate of two. One to go on the tripod here, and one to go on the suction cup mount I put in the car. because right now I have to unscrew it every time, loosen the whole thing up, which means every time I set the camera up, I have to reposition it. Or first world problems. All right, I don't know what the timer was for, but yeah. There we go. I should do a video of, does it actually help me grab things? It doesn't feel any different. Yeah, look at that. Cool, dude. All right, see you tomorrow.